Hello everyone, this is Madhavi Karamudi, Assistant Professor in CSE Department. In this lecture, I'll talk about PHP file handling. So generally, in any programming language, handling with files is very, very important task. So mostly in PHP, if you can handle any kind of web application, definitely there is a need of interacting with the files. So while operating with the files, some of the things you need to remember. So first of all, PHP supports a rich set of predefined functions for working with the files. A few of the functions I'll explain in this session. First, see opening the files using fopen function. So in PHP, if you want to open the existing file, we have fopen function. So for this fopen function, we need to pass two parameters. What file you want to open and in which mode you want to open the file. So this file open function is not only for opening the existing file, and we can also use this function for creating the new files also. Suppose at the time of opening the file, in these following modes, if the file is already existing, then that particular file will be opened on the screen. Suppose if the requested file is not there, then automatically it will create one file with the same name. Then it will open file for us with the specified mode. So in PHP, fopen function is for opening the existing file as well as for creating the file. Now see how many modes we can open the file in the PHP. So here we can open the file in PHP for doing some task in read mode. If you can open the file in read mode, we can only read the contents from the file, but we are not allowed to modify the contents of the file. Suppose if the file mode is W, then we can automatically, the file pointer will be set to the beginning of the file after opening. Then we can add some contents to the file. Okay, if you can see the, if you can open the file in R plus mode, so this will allow us to open for both reading as well as for writing purpose. Suppose if the file is, if you can open the file with the W plus mode, then that indicates that it will allow us to open the file for both reading as well as for writing. Suppose if the specified requested file is not exist, then it will create the file with the specified name, then it will open for us on the screen for both reading as well as writing purpose. But in the case of R plus mode, if the specified file exists, then only it will open for us for reading as well as writing. If the file is not exists, then it will not create the new file. Now see, if the file mode is A, append mode, then already existing file will be opened for us and the file pointer will be kept at the end of the file. That means we will open the file in appending mode only for adding the contents to the existing file. That is the reason why automatically after opening the file pointer will be kept at the end of the file. Suppose if the file does not exist with the specified name, then automatically it will create one file with the specified name and it will open for us for appending purpose. Now A plus mode. If you use A plus mode for opening the file, then it will allow us to open the file for reading as well as for writing. Okay, so here, if the file already exists, then it will open for us for writing purpose. But if the specified file is not exist, then it will create the new file with the specified name and it will allow us to open for writing purpose. Now see the mode X. So this X is also used for opening the file only in write mode. If the file already exists, the open function opens that file. If the file is not exist, then it will return the false. So these are the few important file modes that we need to use while opening the files. Now see the, one example, one simple example. So as we know, always the PHP content we need to write inside the HTML page. So here I have written PHP. PHP starts with question mark PHP tag and ends with the question mark angular bracket. So inside this function, inside this PHP tag, here I am writing code for opening the file. So here I am open, I want to open file.txt file in read mode. Just assume that there is some content in file.txt file. Okay, just for checking whether this fopen function is working or not. Now, here, suppose if this fopen function returns true, if the file already exists and if the file is opened in read mode successfully. Suppose that value will be stored in the variable $handle. Suppose if there is any problem while opening this file, it will return false. Okay, once it is over, then we are checking the value of $handle function. If $value is true, then we want to print one message like file opened successfully. Okay, so as else, suppose if file, is there any problem in opening the file, then it will return false. Then this condition will fail. Then we will come out of the block. So this is just for checking whether the file is opened successfully or not. Now see the second method, fgets method. Once the file is opened successfully, suppose if you want to read the contents from the file, then we need to use fgets function. So the syntax of the fgets function is handle, and it is optional to specify how much content you want to read. Okay, so here this handle indicates the file, which file you want to, from which file you want to read the contents. Okay, see the example here. First, if you want to read the contents from the file, first of all, we need to open that file in the read mode. So here I am opening the file.txt file in read mode. Then if the file is opened successfully without any problem, then it returns, this fopen function returns true. So that value will be stored here. Now here I am writing the code like, if the I need to read all the contents from that file.txt file until the end of the file. So here FEOF function is used for checking whether you reached end of the file or not. So here this condition indicates whether you are not at the end of the file, then read the contents of this file by using fgets function and put that contents in some variable called as f$text. Okay, suppose if you want to know whatever contents, what contents you have in that file, you just print that $text contents. So by printing as it is, after reading each and every line, if you want to insert the break statement, you just insert it. So in PHP, if you want to insert any HTML tags, compulsory the tag should be written inside the double quotes. Okay, so this fread function, fgets function, is used for reading the contents from the file. Like this, we have so many functions for reading contents from the file. We will see all those functions one by one. Now see the next function. If you want to read the contents from the file character by character, then we have fgetc function. So for fgetc function also, we need to pass the file name as a parameter. Right, so here also same, suppose whatever file contents you want to read, first of all we need to open that file. Here just assume that here I am opening this text file in read mode. Okay, if it is success, then that information I am storing in this variable. Okay, here one more condition I am writing, or die unable to open. Suppose if there is any problem while opening this file in read mode, you just kill that connection. So here die method is used for killing the connection. Okay, so once the file is opened successfully, then that file contents will be available in this file. Okay, now I want to read the contents of that file until end of the file, character by character. Okay, so here while not end of the file of $myfile, then read the contents from $myfile character by character by using fgetc function, and at the same time print each and every character by using echo statement. So here itself, whatever character I am reading from the file, directly I am printing that the character on the screen by using echo statement. Okay, we'll see about this fclose function later in next slide. So now see the next function, suppose if you want to read all the contents of the file at once, not character by character or not by string by string, if you want to read the contents of specified file at once, then in PHP we have file underscore get underscore contents function. So for this function also we need to pass file name as a parameter. Okay, see the example. So here first of all we need to open the file in read mode, that is common. So in this program I didn't mention that one. So file open function, so before reading the contents you have to open the file, you just remember it. Okay, now once the file is opened, next I need to read the contents from file.txt. okay, so instead of opening the file directly here, by using file get contents itself we can read the contents from the file directly. So here I am reading the file contents directly, all the contents, and I am placing that contents in one variable. Okay, so now I want to print the contents of this variable. Okay, so here we are not reading line by line and we are not reading the character by character. So this function reads the characters and reads the entire content until end of the line, right? So whenever it finds the slash n character means it is a new line character, just replace that new line character with the break statement. So why we are replacing this new line character with the break statement is just in the output also, if you want to print the same content as it is, how it is there in file.txt, in the same way if you want to print in the output also, including the breaks, here I am writing the statement. So while reading the contents from the dollar handle file, whenever you identify a new line character, you just replace that new line character with the break, so that from the next statement onwards we will print it in the next line. Okay, so like that we are reading the contents and we are placing all those contents in the variable txt. Finally we are printing those contents by using echo statement. Okay, so fgets function is used for reading the contents string by string, fgetc function is used for reading the contents character by character. If you want to read whole file at once, then we need to use file underscore get underscore contents method. Now see the next method, closing a file. So not only with the files, if you are interacting with any kind of resources like files, or if you are interacting with the databases, compulsorily once the task is over, at the end you need to close the resources. If you are not closing the resources, there is a chance of misusing those resources, right? That is the reason why once you are reading or writing task is over, you just close it at the end. So for closing the file in PHP, we have fclose function. So for this fclose function, we need to pass the to which file you want to close, that file we need to pass as a parameter. Okay, see one example for this. So here I am opening the file with read mode. Okay, I am reading all the contents of this file and I am printing those contents. Once all the contents are over, finally I am closing this file by using fclose function. So this is the way to use the close function. Now see the next function, to check before opening the file, definitely we need to check whether the file is exists or not. Okay, anyway, if you are not checking also, if you open the file in read mode, it will open if the file already exists. If you are opening the file in write mode, it will open the file if already exists. Otherwise it will create the new file with the same name and it will open for us. Okay, but in some applications there is a need of checking before the opening itself whether that file is exists or not, then we need to use file exists function. Okay, this function is just for checking whether the file is there in the memory or not. So for that, to whom you want to search that file address, we need to pass as a parameters. See the next function, just for knowing what is the size of your file, we need to use file size function. So for that function, we need to pass file name as a parameter. Okay. Now next function. Suppose if you want to work with the binary files, if you want to read the contents from the binary file, then we need to use fread function. So fread function is also similar to reading the contents from the file, like fgets and fgets function. So here also same purpose. So fread function is for reading the contents of the file until the end of the file. So here, if you want to specify the length, how many lines you want to read, then you can specify the length. Otherwise, until the end of the file, all the contents will be read from the file. Okay. Now next function is, suppose if you want to know the statistics about your file, that means who created the file, when it was created, where the file was stored in the memory, and how many what is the size of your file, who is the creator of your file. So like that, if you want to know the complete information about your file, then we have stat function in PHP. But this stat function will works only in Unix operating system. It will not work in Windows operating system. Okay. So for this stat function, we need to pass the file name as a parameter. Right. So this stat function is for displaying the statistics about your file. Now next function. Suppose you are somewhere in your file. If you want to set the file pointer to the beginning of the file, or if you want to return the current pointer location to the user, or suppose if you want to set the pointer to the end of the file. So in that case, just for knowing the location of the file pointer in the file, we have fseek function. So by using this fseek function, we can know the current location of the file pointer in the file, and we can also set the file location, pointer location to the file. Okay. So here, to which file you want to operate, that file name, and offset indicates these are the ones. So seek underscore set. So this offset, if you use handle comma seek underscore set, then automatically the file pointer will set to the beginning of the file. Suppose if you specify seek underscore cur, and wherever the current pointer location is there, so at the same position itself we will be in the file. Now seek underscore end. So this property tells that sets the pointer to the end of the file. Now another important function is copying the files. Okay, suppose if there is a need of copying from one file to another file, then in PHP we have copy function. So for this copy function, we need to specify source and destination. So see one example. So here there is a file with the name file.txt. Just assume that in this file there are some content. Okay, now I am created one more file, copy.txt. Now I want to copy the contents of file.txt into copy.txt. So in that case, I need to use copy method. Okay, just for the understanding sake, here I am using the condition whether it is copied or not. Suppose if the file contents of $file1 is copied into file2 successfully, then this function returns true. So based on that, I am just printing one message like copied file1 contents successfully. Suppose if this function is returning false, copy function is returning false, that indicates that there is a problem while copying file1 contents into file2. So in that case, else block will be executed, could not copy the file contents. Okay, so this copy function is used for copying one file contents into another file. So here first parameter should be the source file and second parameter should be the destination file. Now see the next file handling function. Suppose if you want to delete the existing file in the PHP, then for that we have unlink function. So for this unlink function, we need to pass the file name as a parameter. Okay, see the example. suppose here also all these file operations are the Boolean operations only. So these functions will return true if that particular operation is success. Otherwise, it will return false. Okay. So here, I just want to delete the file file.txt. Okay. So after unlinking or after deleting, I just want to check whether it is deleted or not. Right. So that is the reason why same function, unlink function, I am writing inside the if condition. Okay. Suppose if this specified file is deleted successfully, then this unlink function returns true. So it will print the message like file deleted. Suppose if there is any problem while deleting this file, then definitely this unlink function will return false. So in that case, it will execute the else block. So it will print the message like could not delete the file. Okay. So from here, what we need to understand is unlink function is for deleting the files from the memory. Okay. Now see write function. Suppose if you want to write some contents into the file. So for that we have fwrite function. So fread function is for reading the contents from the file. Fwrite function for writing the contents into the file. So if you want to write something into the file, definitely we need to open that file in write mode. Okay. If you open the file in read mode, definitely we can't write the contents. So before performing fwrite function, you just open the file in write mode. Then whatever contents you want to write, you just write it into the file. See this example here. First, I am opening the data.txt file in write mode. Okay. So after that, in this file, I want to write the text like, here is some text. This text I want to write into that file. Right? So for this fwrite function, I am passing file name to which file I want to write the contents, that file name, and what contents you want to write, that contents. So that content directly I am not passing, that content I am storing in one variable, and that variable I am passing here as a parameter. So automatically the contents that are there in $text will be will be copied into or write it into $handle file. Okay, this is about file write function. So these are the few file functions that are available in PHP. Like this, we have so many functions to handle with the files. So these are the few files for working with the functions to work with the files in PHP. Okay, so thank you one and all.